Hi, I'm Sherrill from the Sewing Room Channel, and I'm going to give you a couple of quick tips. I'm going to talk about your ruler that works with your rotary cutter. I'm also going to talk about sewing machine needles. So let's first take a look at your ruler. Okay, now rulers, these cutting rulers come in a variety of sizes and shapes. Now it doesn't matter which one you're using, I'm going to mostly focus on where to place the line when you're cutting your fabric, because that's real important. So when you first buy your fabric, you don't get a clean edge like this. It's usually all zigzaggy and threads hanging out all over. It's important before you start cutting is that you clean up the edge of that fabric. So cut off a nice straight line. Then from that nice clean edge, you're going to place one of the lines from your ruler on there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the 2.5-inch line. So 1, 2.5. So I'm going to use this line right here. Now the issue is, where should I place that line? Well, some of you probably think, well, it's obvious on the edge of the fabric. But you should be surprised. By just moving it slightly in the wrong direction can cause all your pieces to come out uneven. So I'm going to show you different ways. So this is the line I'm using right here. I'm going to place it right up against the fabric. Now there's nothing wrong with that, okay? The thing that you have to be careful with is if you place it there, every time you do a cut, you need to place it exactly the same. Now some people like to place it right on top of the fabric. I don't know how well you can see this, okay, but right on top. That's okay, as long as you place it there every single cut. Now some people, believe it or not, even actually will leave a little bit of fabric hanging out past that line. The problem is that some people may have is that sometimes they place it like that, and on their next cut, they move it on top of the line, and then on the next cut, they move it out a little bit, not realizing that every time you put that line in a different place, your pieces are not going to match up. So pick one, use any one, and just make sure you place it in the same exact spot every single time, and you're going to find you have less issues with your pieces matching up. The other thing I want to talk to you about is sewing machine needles, okay? Now I'm not promoting any particular brand of needle. I'm going to focus on what size of needle to use when you're working on a particular type of fabric, because that's real important that you use the correct needle. So let's look at this package of needles right here. The problem with this package is down here where the little numbers are, that tells you the size. But if you don't know what those numbers mean, you're not going to be using the correct needle. You won't know which one to use. And it's very confusing because there's dozens of sizes of needles out there. So you need to know what this means. So what I did was I went to the manufacturer's website, and there was this chart on there, and I printed it out because it's all color-coded, and it tells you, here's the fabric over here, and over here is the size. And in the United States, we use these last two numbers here, this outer sets of numbers, and then this is the metric system over here, okay? So what you want to do is, okay, supposing you're working on stretchy fabric. So right here, it's gold. So you're going to go over to this other side and find gold and come over here to these last couple of numbers here, and you're going to need to use a size 18 for stretchy fabric. And now down here for the quilting, it's kind of a dark olive green. You go over here and it says this. Now all manufacturers might be a little different. And then for top stitching, it's kind of this bluish green. You go down here and it says size 8. And then there's ones for leather, everything. So make sure you look at the fabric first, then go over here, look at the chart, see what size you need. The other thing you need to do is use the correct thread. If you don't have the correct thread, you're not going to get nice looking stitches. So when you go to the sewing machines or go to the fabric store, looking at the thread, there is cotton thread, there is polyester thread, there's rayon thread, there's quilting thread, machine quilting thread, thread for stitching on carpet, there's everything. So make sure you match the thread up to go with the needle, to go with the fabric, and you're gonna find your stitches will come out nice and even. So print this out, go to your manufacturer's website, print it out, stick it up on the wall next to your sewing machine so it's right there for a quick reference. One more thing I want to talk to you about is the point of the needle down there, okay? These wear out. This could also cause issues for you when you're sewing. When you start to hear that needle going clunk, 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 it's dull, it's time to change. So if you sew a lot, you need to change your needle a lot. Okay, very, very important. Well, I hope that these little quick tips help you out for some of you who are just getting into sewing and you're a little confused. I get confused. I don't consider myself an authority on needles and thread, okay? But I do know if all that stuff doesn't work together, your project is not gonna look as nice. Now, if you have any questions, you need help on a project, or you have a suggestion for a video, leave it in the comment section below this YouTube screen. I read all of the comments and I try to answer as many as I can. And if I like your suggestion for the video and I feel it's something that many of the viewers are interested in, I'm glad to do a video on it. Now, if you want to keep informed on all of the videos from the Sewing Room channel, click on subscribe. You know, there's one down there and there's one up there. You guys know the drill. Once you click on one of those, YouTube's going to prompt you for that email address. Enter that so that YouTube will inform you through an email. You click on the button in the center of that email, it's going to take you directly to my latest video. I'm Sherrill. I'm so glad you came to my sewing room. I've got a lot more blogs to come. I'll see you next time, and happy sewing.